Here starts our vlog. We are, what time is it? 4 a.m.?
Here's Pop Pop.
Yeah, shelter 11.
And Mama and Day Day. David's excited.
Here we go. So
awesome. I'll just find a point of the three. The stroller, and we're headed to Terminal B. We're gonna pass by the Disney store here, though. I didn't get a picture of it coming up.
We're delighted to have you as our guests. Your safety and comfort are of the utmost importance to us, so we appreciate your attention as we share some important safety instructions. You can store your carry-on items in the overhead bins or under your seat. Please do not place items in the aisle.
some beautiful pictures.
Look.
You remember your vacation in the most magical place on earth.
Oh,
and you must be. Now you can record a good video. Beautiful pictures. Woo, 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 woo. You remember your vacation in the most magical place on earth. And you must be. Now you can record a good video. Beautiful pictures. Woo, 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 woo.
So we're here, just checked in. Everybody's excited. David keeps on asking, wake me up when we're here. And we're like, David, we're already here. Excited?
Yes.
Pop-up's excited. He's hungry though.
Yeah.
All right, so we're gonna see what we're gonna eat. We'll let you know here in a second. What?
Here's Mama.
Mama had to go to the bathroom.
Yeah.
Day Day. What is this? Let me see the face. Mini arcade in here. Something to eat. Manny's gonna try to get something Earl's sandwich. Mr. Rob.
What am I doing? Oh, yeah, Cuban.
Cuban.
Cuban sandwich.
What are you getting, Mandy?
Turkey holiday sandwich.
What about you, Day Day? What are you gonna get?
I'm gonna get the. I think.
He has to think about it.
Yeah, I might try the tortilla soup.
Oh, he's already looked it
chicken
all up.
Chicken tortilla soup.
He's already looked it all up.
I have to do something while I was in the bathroom.
I'm going to get back to you on what I'm getting. I don't even know what I'm going to get. I'll just, whatever I feel like.
Down to 42 grams, and my wife and I
Disney Springs. Alright, well, David fell asleep on the boat. He's now asleep in his little carrier here, or stroller, I mean. He I don't think he took a nap yesterday. And obviously we woke up at 3 a.m. and he's been going ever since. He did not sleep on the plane because he was too excited about being on the plane. But now he's crashing, which is probably good so he can get his nap in and we can enjoy the night. So we're letting him crash. Mandy and Mr. Rob went into Earl of Sandwich to grab something to eat because we haven't eaten all morning. And we're in Disney Springs. So no plans till tonight. Just having a fun time, enjoying everything and getting to explore Disney Springs again, like always. I haven't decided what I want to eat yet either, so that's kind of up in the air. But I'm sure I'll figure that out here soon.
Cuban and chicken tortilla soup.
Ooh.
It's probably been 6 years since I had that.
Good. A plus?
Mm-hmm.
All right, gonna go to the Christmas store here. Ghirardelli. Manny has put in a special request for a Ghirardelli.
And a caramel hot chocolate.
Chocolate. You could smell. Great. Got some Ghirardellis. Chocolate on top, but we're going to put inside of it and let it melt. We always get this now. Day Day. Is it good? How good?
So good.
So good.
So good? So I'm gonna get some polite pig for me and Day Day while Mama, Pop Pop go get on Gideon's.
The virtual queue for Gideon's. It is 110 minutes, so about 2 hours. And now we are headed back to find Robbie. Pop-Pop may or may not be trying to look at the menu for the Hangar Bar. It's now not called the Hangar Bar, it's called the Holiday.
All right, got the Blake Pick beer flight. Apple cider, whiskey sour. It's a slider trio with three different meats. I think it's the chicken, the brisket, and the pulled pork. David got pulled pork, fries, waffle fries with rub on it. Looks really good. All right, so Polite Pig was amazing. The beer flight was okay, but the apple cider whiskey was really, really good. But pork sliders and the brisket slider and the chicken slider was excellent. Definitely do it again. Even the fries were good with the rub on them. What'd you think?
It was really good. We've been talking about doing Polite Pig for like 5 years and we finally did it.
And Papa enjoys eating the leftovers from Day Day. Robbie having a couple sips of drink.
Mandy,
everybody. He's like the garbage disposal
that
keeps on eating.
So we're still in the virtual queue for Gideon's, which is probably about another hour wait. We're trying to figure out what to do. We went to the Characters in Flight and it's too windy, so it's closed. And as we were sitting there trying to figure out what to do, David said, "I want to dig fossils." So that's what we're about to do.
Dig some fossils.
Dig some fossils. Mind you, this was not a suggestion we brought up on our own. This was all him.
This is all David.
All David. So here we go. T-Rex Cafe. Gym. I don't know if it's a blessing or a curse because we may be here a while, but it's free, it's fun, and a four-year-old loves it. Alright, so I got my notification that our virtual queue is up for Gideon's cookies. And I think I got in the virtual queue around 12:30 and it is 1:40. So that was only like 70 minutes and it said it was gonna be 110 minute wait. So we are walking over to
You forgot
Gideon's.
To bless you to me.
Bless you. I don't know if you heard that. That was pretty funny. He sneezed and then he was like, "You forgot to say bless you to me." That's my child. So anyway, we're over to walk to Gideon's. And get our cookies.
I know. I was tempted to come get these today too.
I always thought this was part of regular road.
I don't need a coffee, but
so what's on the front? Oh, just the picture. You ready to go inside and get some cookies?
Oh, man.
collects antique books. And he collected an antique cookbook years ago. And it was copyrighted in 1898. It was a Victorian cookbook.
All right.
Where's my cookie?
Oh, that's the, that is a special edition.
That's pumpkin.
Pumpkin.
They said.
Where's mine?
We're sharing.
That's
one.
About 5,000 carbs.
Chocolate
3 hour wait.
This is the one.
Do what you got to do.
David, you got to cover your mouth. Can
I see that one? I want a chocolate chip.
Good. Great. He's all about it. There you go. One bite. Is it good?
Yeah. Can we share a chocolate chip?
What do you think, Papa? Is it good?
Share it.
One more bite, and then we're going to go.
That's a lot of bites. Oh my gosh, how much did you stuff in your mouth just then?
One bite? No, I'm good right now. I got some for the later. Is it still as good as it was the first time?
Also, I've heard about the nitro cold brews they have here, so I got the limited edition French toast one to try. And I'm a really strong coffee girl. I like it black.
Uh-huh.
This is like zero coffee, straight sugar. I'm not gonna be able to drink it. But someone that likes straight sugar, go for it. Dad also does not like sugary coffee, so I'm gonna let him try it and not tell him and see what he thinks.
Try the cold brew.
That's 100 calories in that sip.
What do you think?
David loves it.
Yeah, David loves
it. Oh,
need some amaretto.
All right, going back to Old Key West. Check into our room. Shower, rest up for Mandy's birthday dinner tonight. There's the one we're staying at. First floor. Here's our room. David, show us around the room.
Mickey Mouse.
Mickey Mouse? Is there an outside? Come show us outside.
Here's two.
We got a nice little balcony here. You can see the
two chairs.
The waterway here that we just passed. We got some Mickey's. Look, there's some Mickey's there. And that is to the other unit. So if we did a combined unit or a bigger unit. little kitchenette and the bathroom. These are weird shaped buildings, but in doing so, where they're weird shaped, these rooms actually are bigger than most. You get a little bit more room because of the odd shapes, but it's a nice little room. Room for luggage underneath the bed too. We got our welcome home Holland party.
The beds are comfortable. That's
tired.
A plus.
And
we woke up at 3:15. The alarms went off this morning. But cool thing is we learned that today is Mickey Mouse's birthday and he's 94 years old.
Huh?
He's 94.
And he doesn't look an age over 10.
Yeah.
He ages really well. You couldn't
tell. That explains why we got a button that says Happy Birthday, Minnie and Mickey.
It's a special button.
Yeah.
So we're here on his birthday.
Yeah, pretty cool.
So, pretty cool. David celebrated a birthday this month for 4. Manny celebrates her birthday this month for 37.
Not true. In the right decade, but not the right year.
But we're relaxing. We might get a minivan to go over to our dinner tonight.
I vote minivan.
Because Manny wants to celebrate her birthday in style. She's looking forward to this dinner.
Hopefully I'm hungry for it.
I think we'll be hungry.
It's like in 4.5 more hours. So.
Yeah. I'm sure Pop-Up could fit something somewhere in 4 hours. Well, we've already been charged, so if you don't fit, it doesn't matter. You still pay the same amount.
Oh, we've already been charged for dinner tonight?
Yes.
It was
a prefixed menu with a prefixed charge. So,
What's the restaurant called? California Grill?
Yeah. No. It's California Grill.
California Grill 50th anniversary dinner is what we're doing.
We'll be adjacent to the Top of the World. We're going to try to do Top of the World next time. I think we can reserve that here in a couple days. Right?
I think so.
So, I'm going to do the new fireworks and dessert party they have going on there, which is for DVC members only.
Yep.
We tried to do it in less time, but they were completely booked, except for Sunday, which that's our day we're going to Magic Kingdom, so that doesn't even work. So next time with Will.
Yeah, we're gonna try tonight to do some gingerbread houses at the Monorail Resorts and watch the fireworks, which I think are at 10 p.m. if we make it that long. But we can, I think with our receipt from a reservation, we can go back up there even if we're done eating and watch it from the restaurant. Like, they have a viewing area for the fireworks.
So we can enjoy it there.
Yeah, it'll be fun.
Oh, yeah.
I think we might take a nap now.
I'm falling asleep already.
But we have 4.5 hours, so it's all good. Yeah. We got time. Longest day ever.
Got a minivan.
Hello.
Good evening.
Hey, how are you?
Mickey send that for you?
We told him Mickey specifically sent it for him to go to dinner.
He did. Mickey called me and said, I'm gonna pick you up.
Oh my gosh. That's an unbelief right there. David, is that cool? Yeah. David, look. He's excited. Are you happy?
She's leaving me already. So that was in 95. In 99, we saw an opportunity. We moved down.
Okay.
So I was supposed to work for Disney, but the position went from full-time to part-time when I got down.
Okay.
So I couldn't do part-time. And that's when I went over to Mears Transportation. And they hired me. I drove for them for almost 2 years. So I moved into their training department.
When you did Mears, were you with them when they were doing the Disney transportation?
I was, but I wasn't a driver.
Okay.
I worked in the safety department for the last 15 years.
Okay.
Or more, actually, I was quasi-safety when I was training. Because when I was training, I was also working, doing safety training classes, and then I was doing accident investigations for the company.
I gotcha.
But then I got a position as a safety compliance manager.
Uh-huh.
Got my own office, weekends and holidays off. It was a great job. Yours is a good company to work for. I lost my job to COVID.
Okay.
And the position was actually eliminated about 8 months.
Okay.
Into the COVID era. They notified me and they said, Tom, I said, well, is there any other positions in safety available? And they said, no. What about HR? And they said, no. And I said, well, they said, well, come back and drive a bus. I said, no, I don't want to drive a motor coach anymore. I did that. My career was driving, driving motor coach anymore.
Yeah.
So I retired at 63, collected my partial, my Social Security benefit, took a little reduction. And after about a year of retirement, I found myself crawling the walls looking for something to do, so I looked at Disney's career website and I saw this position.
Uh-huh.
So knowing that this position is normally filled by internal cast members,
right?
I said, well, let me give it, since they advertised it, let me apply. So I applied, I interviewed a couple times, I took a couple quizzes, and here I am.
Wow.
I feel fortunate because, like I said, the positions are normally filled by internal.
Hey. Give him a high five.
High five. Good job. So,
thank you.
You're welcome now.
So, Data got his minivan from Mickey. It's pretty cool. And, oh, he has his other watch that helps us track him. We're going to get his other magic band fixed. And we're going to get that fixed right now. We're at the contemporary's desk. And Mama is going to get her birthday pin. That way,
everyone knows.
She can celebrate her birthday. And Pop-Up wants his next.
My what?
Your birthday pin.
I want my retirement pin back.
We're getting our magic bands fixed and I'm getting my birthday pin, and David was getting a little restless, so we found the little kid section where he can watch TV, so he is now content.
All right, you ready, Day-Day? Go. Well, it's not on this floor anyway. It's on like the second floor. I think it's this way. What's this? Is this the gingerbread house?
We found it.
What did we get? Get some gingerbread?
Got a brick.
A brick. Gingerbread brick.
Classic treat, Cascade Roll, U.S. Rock Shrimp, Duck,
They said there was fireworks at 10 o'clock. And there we go, cool. David, what is that? Is that cool? You want to try it? Is it good?
This is Shirley Temple. Do you like it?
Yeah.
Yeah. This is. All right. Repeat what he said.
I cannot, because he messed it up twice.
It's bread.
It's like fennel
with olive oil
and something, rosemary, piccata. I don't know. This is tomato and
what
olive
is it again?
Oil.
Say it again.
The official name is a tomato schmutz. It's extra virgin olive oil with roasted Roma tomatoes, a little bit of chives as well.
And what's the bread?
This is a rosemary fennel focaccia bread.
That's what it is.
Rosemary fennel focaccia. Alright.
So I got the duck pizza. I don't. Oh, I got the wontons. Mama got the.
I forget what it's called. It's sushi.
We have our cascade roll. We have some wakame seaweed salad. On top is on top of our cucumber and avocado veggie roll. We have a poke mix made with yellowtail, salmon, and tuna. Right, next, we have our beautiful house-made chicken noodle soup. Probably the best chicken noodle soup you'll have. We make the pasta in-house. We make the broth fresh every day, and then we have fresh cut vegetables as well. All right. Beautiful. Here we have our duck a l'orange pizza made with a house-made semolina flour crust. We have duck confit and duck prosciutto, blue cheese crumbles, and a blue cheese garlic cream base. We have some nice arugula, pickled red onions, a cherry compote, and a little bit of balsamic glaze. One more for the camera.
Yeah, you got to get a video of that.
There we go. Last but not least, is my favorite. These are our braised short rib wontons. So underneath the wontons is a miso cola onion sauce. So we use red miso, a Korean soybean paste called doenjang, coke syrup, and caramelized onions. On top of our braised short rib wontons, we have three things. We have pickled lotus root, we have scallions, and then we have some watermelon radishes as well to kind of round out those flavors. All right, please enjoy, guys.
Awesome. I got the grouper. David got mac and cheese.
I need a spoon.
And both Robbie and I got the fillet.
Try it.
Hi, it's me again. All right, so we're moving on to the next course. May I borrow this from you real quick, sir? All right. So here we have our beautiful oak fire fillet of beef, 7 ounce Angus fillet, topped with tomato butter. We also have some asparagus, cauliflower puree, and some Chateau potatoes, which are baby Yukon Gold that we pressed down, and then we flash fry real quick. And then just around everything else, golden raisin vinaigrette. Over here, we have our Florida black grouper, served with a Thai green curry sauce, coconut jasmine rice. We have three different vegetables. We have shiitake mushrooms, bok choy, and shishito peppers. On top of our seared grouper is a chili cashew chutney, as well as a little bit of saffron. For this young man over here, for all the parents, we have some beautiful brown basmati rice, some steamed green beans, and house-made shells and cheese. You may recognize these pasta shells from the chicken noodle soup. It's the same thing. So still made in-house, but now with this beautiful cheese sauce.
It's really good.
Yeah. Enjoy, everyone.
Thank you.
I started off with a pizza. I could not tell you everything on it. I think it was duck and some orange marmalade and like 10 more other ingredients. That was a pan-crusted special, which you already saw, but it was the best pizza probably I've ever had, and it was very unique. So probably I've never tasted anything like that pizza ever again. And then the steak, which Mandy's gonna vouch for me, it melts in your mouth. You didn't even have to chew it. Basically, the best steak you'll ever taste, with all kinds of different things around it. Like you're just dipping it in and soaking it up in every bite. Which Mandy didn't finish. I finished my whole plate because it was that good. Everything's good. The regular dessert, and I'm sure that's going to be just as good. The bread was good. The water is 3 times filtered water. Amazing. The sake, amazing. I have no complaints.
So I get to go second on the review. So for appetizer, I had the beef wonton, and they were really, really good. The sauce was so good that I had to eat extra bread just to sop it up. So they cleaned the bowl. And then for the entree, I had the black grouper on a bed of rice with a chutney sauce that was surrounded by this bok choy and water chestnuts and mushrooms in a butter sauce. And it was really good. And now I'm getting ready to have some coffee and creme brulee.
Alright, so I had the sushi and it was so fancy, I don't even know what was on it, but it was really good. But the thing that stood out is that it had like mint and cilantro on top, which gave it a distinct flavor because I've never had sushi with cilantro on it. I didn't like the mint as much, but the cilantro on the sushi was really good. And then I had the steak. It was an oak-fired filet, and it was one of the most tender steaks I've had. It's up there with Jiko, the boars, what is it called?
The tenderloin?
Yeah, the boar tenderloin. It was like very similar.
Tenderloin medallions.
Yeah, at Jiko. It was similar to that. It was definitely a good pick for a birthday celebration, and I'm about to get the five samplers of all the desserts. And David had chicken noodle soup, which was really good. He, with my help, having to spoon feed him, ate the whole thing. And then he had mac and cheese, which I also tried. We all tried. It was very, very good. And he had green beans, and all of a sudden he didn't realize they were there because they were hiding, and he was like, beans, and then started picking them up with his fingers eating them. So, but I did not finish my steak. I ate half. And we took home the rest of David's mac and cheese, but he did finish all of his chicken noodle soup, and now we have coffee, like they said, and dessert left.
Up to standard with these descriptions.
Oh my.
I need the extra Ryan touch with these pastry
extra Ryan
marks.
Touch. So, I should expect this from him. So the five, Magical Bites are in honor of the five premier chef de cuisine at California Grill, and I've gotten to work with them all. California Grill opened Mother's Day of 95. I started June of 97 at Disney World at Grand Floridian. I came up here in December of 99, so December 1st will be 23 years here at California Grill. Cliff Poe and George Meliotis were the opening team. If you're familiar with Wine Bar George at Disney Springs, that's George with whom I interviewed for this job.
Okay.
23 years ago. George, as you see, made it back. Cliff is with Charlie Steakhouse, executive level. Cliff and George, this was their brainchild. So California Cuisine, What's in Season, the Onstage Kitchen. Cliff's dessert, actually butterscotch creme brulee, it's in the form of cheesecake, just for presentation, same flavor profile. However, cheesecake's a little more dense, so if you ever see a butterscotch creme brulee, get it, it's so good.
Yeah.
The first time I ever had creme brulee that wasn't vanilla, which is how we could come up with the Grand Marnier. So, because of the seasonality of the menu in the past, I've had pumpkin for fall. I've had chocolate for winter. I've had it's so good. Now, Cliff and George left Disney together in 2000 to create Seasons 52. So if you're ever at Seasons, remember this menu because Cliff helped build them both. The pork entree on that menu is Cliff's, unchanged, 27 years.
Wow.
Now jump over to the Honey Crunch Cake. That's 2002. John State was the first chef named to replace Cliff, coming from the Flying Fish. I loved working with him. Basically, we were, you know, our leaders abandoned us, so now what do we do? So we worked together really quite nicely. From here, John helped to open up the JW Marriott at SeaWorld, and then he had his own Seasons up in Chicago, and just recently back out west with Disney in Anaheim. Jump up to the lemon curd with a little blueberry. That's 2007. Jens Stallman was our chef, also from the Flying Fish. Jens is Austrian, so you're going to find that this one will not be so sweet as American desserts. I would say it's more refreshing, nice light texture, nice lemon acidity. Jens became executive chef at Epcot Center from here.
Okay.
Jump down to the chocolate pudding cake, 2015. This is the polar opposite of the lemon curd. It is rich and intense. It's got a little salt on top, which just intensifies the chocolate. That's Brian Piasecki. Brian was, he had his vision. And I liked working with him because here you go. He is still, and I think because of that vision, he's still at Disney World and he's in charge of menus now. So he's in charge of all the quick service for every resort. And he's in charge, he helped to create the menu for the Star Cruiser at Star Wars.
Yeah, yeah.
So his vision is, you know, his vision is still all over Walt Disney World. Now, Daniel has his carrot cake. Daniel, until about a month ago, has been my chef for a good 5 years. I would say this is the beginning of what we call the Disney Shuffle. So about 5 or 6 years, they start switching all the chefs. So Daniel went to the Coronado Tower.
Okay.
Robbie came from Coronado to here, but Robbie's already gone, so we're waiting for somebody to be placed.
Okay.
Just in time for a season to start next week.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah.
So things are always changing, and our menu, that this format is a year old now, and I like it. It makes it easy. It's, in a lot of ways, it's easier for me, but I miss the seasonality of the old menu. It's a little freer, but we're getting there. So I'm hoping because I would like for, you know, fish to be more seasonal, and maybe have a bison option like we used to have when we had a wagyu option. I'm hoping.
Yeah.
So we're getting back there. So sure.
That sounds good.
Now in the center is a little raspberry coulis underneath the chocolate coin. So that'll be a little bit tart.
Yeah.
There you go.
Cool. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Ryan. Here, just in case you want to edit it out, just so it's like extra short for like YouTube, maybe.
Yes.
So we have our 5 magical bites, 50 years in the making. These are inspired by the 5 chef cuisines we've had at California Grill since 1995. What this gentleman right here is picking up is our 50th anniversary chocolate coin on top of a raspberry foam. We have a carrot cake with candied carrot, candied walnut, a little bit of gold leaf. We have our butterscotch cheesecake with basil sugar and macerated strawberries.
Thank you, buddy.
We have our chocolate pudding cake with Nutella, mulled on sea salt, and a mint meringue. Fourth one's our honey crunch cake with whipped cream, pressed pineapple, and a chocolate bead. Last but not least is our lemon curd with blueberry and sponge cake.
All right.
And over here we have our beautiful Grand Marnier. Get up close again.
Nice.
All right. Grand Marnier creme brulee, hibiscus meringue stripes, crystallized coconut, and a pineapple mango compote as well. And creme brulee is put on top of a white chocolate whisk. All right, please enjoy, guys.
Thank you.
That's a chocolate chip cookie.
What'd you get?
See, now you got the best cookie.
Thank you. Do you want to hear the bell?
Do I want to hear it?
The bell? With tip?
Yeah.
461.
Only $460.
You only had a 31st birthday once.
Dad says you only have a 31st birthday once.
You can say that about every birthday. You only have a 32nd, 33rd.
fallen asleep at the very finale of these fireworks, like watching them fall asleep.
So how was the first day?
A long day, but a good day.
Did you enjoy your birthday?
I did, even though it's not my birthday, but this is the official day we're celebrating my birthday.
That was a pretty big birthday dinner.
Yeah.
Yeah, so David is gone. He fell asleep at the fireworks. He's had a long day.
He's had a big day.
Yes, but
he
it's going to be...
an afternoon nap.
Paolo's looking forward to sleeping, too.
Oh, my tummy's full.
Paolo might want some of my medicine for nighttime.
Yeah.
Well, we got a minivan.
Thank
another
goodness.
One.
Yes.
Because when in Rome,
right.
Why take the bus?
The food was so good. I don't know how we can hear our reviews on the camera when we were there because of the background noise, but it was so, so, so good.
Yes, it was some of the best we've ever had.
Best steak.
Best everything.
Mm-hmm. It's okay. Let me turn down the music. David?
Wanna give him a high five? Give him a high five.
Would you like a Mickey or a Minnie? You like Mickey. So, you know, it's Mickey's birthday today, so.
Wow.
Oh my goodness.
Say thank you.
You're welcome. I really thought I was going to lose you on that ride. The way you looked when you came out of the resort, I'm like, oh, he's going to go right to sleep. But no, it kept him up, so. Bye,
so David got this from our Lyft driver. I believe his name was Jason. And Jason actually drew this for Day Day. And it's Mickey Mouse, because David wanted Mickey Mouse. He's going to take it home and put it on the wall. That is so cool.
No, put it next to a Mickey thing.
Oh, the Mickey things. He knows where to put it. Because, yes.
Oh.
What?
I did a mobile machine come up. On
the
TV.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And what is today's special day for Mickey Mouse? It's his...
Birthday!
And it's how many years?
94.
Wow. That is so cool. Well, happy birthday, Mickey. We all had a good night. And we are going to go now, call it the end of the day, and sleep. So, we will see you in the morning, but not at 3 this time.
We're calling
a lid.
We're tapping out.
We're tapping out on this one. All right, we'll see you in the morning.